What's up guys, Huawei is back in the news. Today we have so much stuff to talk about. For the first time, Huawei Mate 30 got leaked. And also we have a news regarding the Huawei New Year situation. And not only that, we also have some leaked details, product specifications and release date about the upcoming Kirin 990 and Kirin 985. So first up, Mate 30 Pro, which is now confirmed to have a circular camera setup on the back. This thing is confirmed by Casemaker, but I think Casemakers didn't have enough information. Like, they are showing a 5 cameras and 2 LED flashes, whereas the Mate 30 Pro is going to have a quad camera setup in a circle. And on the sidebar, it will have a xenon flash or maybe a big LED flash, not sure about it. Also, as we know, Huawei Mate 30 Pro will have a waterfall display, or should I say extremely curved edge display, which can touch the back panel of the device, which means it will have almost non-existent side frame. So where will be the power and volume buttons? So previously we were expecting that it's going to have a pressure sensitive sensors on the side edge, but we were wrong. This guy found out from leaked image that Mate 30 Pro is actually going to have a sliding sensors to control volume. As you can see in leaked image, this case has a very big cutout. It also has one small red colored button, which is actually a power button, but next to it here is nothing except this empty space. So you just have to slide your finger to control volume. Also, alongside the Pro model, now the display assembly of standard variant also got leaked, showing the notch is still here, but this time it's a small notch, not like the water drop notch, because it has now more sensors in the notch. Not sure for what, but according to rumors, it is for 3D Face ID sensors. So I don't know how Huawei is gonna implement 3D Face ID sensors in such a small space. I mean, Huawei Mate 30 Pro also has Face ID, but that phone has a wider notch than this. Maybe it's because Face ID on Mate 30 isn't as secure as on the Pro model. And looking at the front of the display, the bezels are here extremely small with flat screens, so no waterfall for Mate 30. And as for the US and Huawei, so as you know, Trump has issued another 90 days of temporary license to Huawei before they take any final decision. But things is now getting even worse. Trump has tweeted out saying to American companies, and I quote, "Immediately start looking for an alternative to China, including bring your companies home and making your products in the US. So right now, Apple and Huawei are in big trouble, and I think Huawei is actually not, because Apple has their 55% market based on their iPhone, which sold mostly in China, whereas Huawei's 50% smartphone market is in their homeland, China. Also, Huawei has announced HarmonyOS as an Android alternative. If things are not in control of Huawei, then they has option in the form of HarmonyOS. And they are also working on Google Maps alternative, I've talked about it before. And not only that, they are also working on Gorilla Glass alternative as well. So Huawei is pretty much saved here, whereas in Apple's case, Foxconn is the company who assembles iPhone, and most of them done in China. So yeah, Apple has to do something. And now finally, as for the Kirin power, so Huawei has announced that they are launching the new 2020 standard Kirin chipsets on 6th of September at IFA 2019 in Berlin, Germany. Also, Yanming Wang, president of Huawei CE, confirmed to TechRadar that the new flagship grade processor from Huawei is indeed called as the Kirin 990. Yanming also confirmed that the Kirin 990 will be built on a 7-nanometer process and will be more power efficient than its predecessor. He also says that the new chipset will power flagship smartphones from the brand in 2020 and comes with support for all mainstream 5G bands. And as for the Kirin 985, so this great leaster says that there will also be a Kirin 985, which is going to be a competitor of Snapdragon 855 Plus, which is just an overclocked version of Snapdragon 855. According to him, Huawei Mate 30 will feature a Kirin 985, while the Mate 30 Pro will rock a Kirin 980, which is the full-on chip from Huawei. And Mate 30X will feature a Kirin 985, but with Belong 5000 modem for 5G connectivity. So yeah, that's all we have on Huawei. Make sure to subscribe to stay tuned with all the latest Huawei and Mate 30's coverage, and yeah, see you soon.